The event sparked some concerns about the president's own health, particularly this moment over the weekend where he cautiously descended a ramp during the commencement speech at West Point Academy. The last thing I was going to do is fall for the fake news to have fun with. There's no indication, however, that the ramp was slippery on a clear, sunny day.
A lot of people talking about this. People always have something to say and weigh in on this. But I'll start with the end, which is that there's a lot of clues in there, but no conclusions. Is it balance problems? Is there some weakness there? Is there numbness in the feet, perhaps a type of neuropathy? Is it just a slippery ramp, as the president said, or slippery shoes?
President Trump also raised some questions during his West Point speech after taking a moment to sip some water by holding the glass with his right hand, but needing further assistance from his left.
I'm prepared to say that I have a record of over 40 years and that I'm going to beat Joe Biden. I'm going to beat Joe Biden.
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by go, you know the thing.
They can't build any factories or anything within 1 mile of the estuary of the Delaware River and the Atlantic Ocean and the Chesapeake. And so the whole point of this is that we can do a lot to deal with endangered species. And one of the things I would like to raise is that we have to deal with this on an international basis as well, because right now, for example, we have a thing, you know, Brazil.
Because they invaded another country and annexed a significant portion of it called Crimea.
Right.
He's saying that it was President, my boss, it was his fault.
Politico reporting this morning that more than a dozen lawmakers met with a Yale psychiatrist last month for a briefing about Trump's mental health. Dr. Bandy Lee warns Trump is going to get worse and it will become uncontainable.
Once you start out with the idea, with the understanding that this is a very sick man, he is truly very sick, then nothing is surprising. Going forward, I will not be surprised by anything. If he were to try to dissolve the Constitution, that wouldn't shock me. Fire the Supreme Court, wage nuclear war on North Korea. These things might seem shocking, but they're consistent.
I know he's mentally ill. I know what mental illness looks like. Donald Trump is mentally ill, but on top of his mental illness, he's a sociopath. So he'll never get help because sociopaths don't feel.
My two greatest assets have been mental stability and being, like, really smart, going on to say he is a very stable genius.